So as you can see, I've got what we call in the UK a people carrier. Not sure what you call them in America. I think SUV or something like that. I'm not sure. Anyway, it's one of these 7-seat cars. And I never use the back seats. Both my children are grown up now, and I've only ever had 2 children. So to have the 4 captain chairs, which are, you know, 4 single chairs in the front, all with armrests, was all we ever needed. So the rear seats were never in here. And I used to carry my kit in here quite a lot. And then there was never any room for when you go shopping and doing your normal stuff. So I put in this false floor. And it's quite high off the ground. It's about 8 inches off the ground. But now it enables me to carry, you know, a lot of my sort of hiking kit that I use virtually every day in the car, as well as emergency breakdown kit, first aid kit, and some type of, if you want to call it bug out or survival type stuff. Basically, I use it as an overnight stuff. It's like camping equipment. So if I'm going to go away somewhere overnight, I know I've got food, I've got water, I've got sleeping arrangements all stored in this car. Okay, so I'll go through briefly with the sort of stuff I'm carrying. So in here is my boot bag. Nothing too exciting about that. This little bag here, this is my overnight bag or a toilet bag. And I've got towel, shower gel, so same sort of stuff as you'd expect. In here is, this bag doesn't always stay in here. This is the sort of stuff I take out on sort of the day trips that I do and some of the day hikes, okay? So, you know, my knife's in here, my tinder bag's in here, my utility pouch, the possibles pouch is in here, there's some water in here, and that sort of stuff, okay? So that's like an everyday bag. It's not always in here, but it does fit in here if I need it to. On the side here, 10 litres of water. And I've got to say, actually, this is, you know, really, really handy. I've got to say, this has actually been is really useful. You know, not only as a drinking supply, but if your car overheats, you've got, you know, a means of getting yourself home. And I've actually used my water on 3 occasions, actually. Twice in traffic jams where I've been sat on the motorway for several hours, you know, and I've got water obviously with me, which I was able to use myself and share to other people on the motorway. But also I met someone who'd actually broken down and their car was overheating and was able to basically top their water supply back up again and limp them, get them more release and get them a bit further anyway. So on here is my wool smock, which you've all seen in other videos, and one of my waterproof jackets. So in this box is really sort of my sort of overnight and camping stuff. So big bundle of rope, just as a backup. Various packets of military food, some of their biscuits. Okay, all this stuff's in here just because it's really long life, long lasting. Couple of packets of salami, again unopened, but these are really long, really have a really long shelf life. Trying to sort the dates on these up. Well, actually, these are running out October 11, so I'll have to eat these pretty soon. Another MRE chicken soup, so that's there. A couple of metal plates, trays, you know, handy for a lot of things, but, you know, just something I could cook up. It's pretty much indestructible. In here is a kaizu, a storm shelter, what's the other name they call it? Kaizu and body bag. So that's what's in here. It's a 3-person tent or temporary tent. That's in here just again for emergencies. Gas stove. I'm pretty sure you would have all have seen these pretty much everywhere. big camping gas stove, that's in here. Spare gas bottle. Zebra billy can, again containing some maths, ball sweets in there, oatmeal blocks, fruit sweets, raisins, tea, coffee, sugar, milk, whitener, all that sort of stuff's in there. Toilet roll. A box of CDs. Do you know what? I get asked for these all the time. So a box of CDs, packet of tissues, a small fire lighting kit, a bowl, fold up shovel, a packet of rice, leather gloves, and an axe. Now down the centre here, again, it's partly because I use this car for work. So there's three bows for the bow drill, three metal rods that I use as my tripod. I carry my camera tripods, my monopods in here, and there's a couple of umbrellas. And then on this side is my NATO bottle with its canteen cup, my large first aid kit that stays in here. Some archery targets, because we do archery with some of the students, and they're just in here, but should have put away. Now in this box on the other side, this is like my breakdown box, so just a bit of cardboard or rubbish that should have been thrown away. My tow rope's out because I had to use it a few days ago. So there's a sunscreen for the front of the car. Tow rope, as I said. There's various straps in here, which are for the roof rack. Set of very large, heavy duty jump leads. These are actually big enough to start a truck. Okay, so, you know, very big ones. There's a torch. Electric compressor. As I said, that's my bag of straps that I use for the roof rack. Little emergency rescue blanket. Again, it's on this side because this is my breakdown side, so that's on this side. There's a toolkit in here. There's a small hammer. Antifreeze, pre-mixed, that's in here. High-vis jackets, in case I break down the side of the road. This is a funnel. So what you can do is you put this into your car and you can actually pour your fluid in. Say, for example, I was trying to get this into my car. I can put that over the top, like that. And then it enables me to then tip with more accuracy into the area. So that's what that's for. Crowbar. Lots of uses for this actually. I use it as a lever. I mean, I used to install safes with these, okay, so I know they're very strong, but use it as a lever, as a pry bar. But also, you know, if you ever come across an RTA, road traffic accident, and you know someone's trapped in a car, with something like this you could actually jimmy a door open or something like that. So this one's brand new, it's never been used, as you can see. A large bow saw, just don't know, might come in handy. Assortment of cable ties, reflective warning triangle, selection of bulbs, and then a few more cable ties, leather gloves, and a little towel for wiping your hands up afterwards. And then down the back on this side, I've got a string here to pull it out, quite a way in. heavy duty plastic, make ground sheets, make it into temporary tents if I need to, that sort of stuff. Nice thick army blanket. And a good three-season sleeping bag. So like I've said before, I'm not particularly a survivalist, but it's always worth being prepared. And, you know, I haven't necessarily got the stuff in my car for, you know, an end of the world scenario or whatever, but it's stuff that's convenient. It's stuff that I may never use, but it's stuff that if I, you know, if I do go away somewhere and I need one to do an overnight, particularly if we go to the wilds, you know, we go somewhere like Dartmoor or something, you know, if it gets really bad on that, you know, I've always got my car, we can always, if we have to, hike back to the car and sleep in the car. And what I'm able to do with this car is these two seats here, I've had swivels put on the bottoms of them, so they turn round, which gives me a flat floor right through. And it's perfectly long enough for me to sleep in here. Someone to about sort of 6 foot or so can sleep out in here. If you was much taller than that, thinking of John Mack now, okay, 6 foot six plus, yeah, you might be a little bit pushed on the foot end, okay, but it's good enough for me. And so thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.